I want to not just display a column, I want to add a column that doesn't exist yet. It's not in my list of columns, and I know that because if I click Add Column, Show or Hide Columns, it's not in this list of unchecked items. What I want is a column to allow my users to categorize a document with a system that we use. A document's either a draft, it's in review, it's finalized, or it's inactive. And so we're going to add a new column. Now, when I add a new column, I need to choose what type it is. Well, I want to use choice because that's going to allow me to offer a set of choices to my users. There are other options here, and I would encourage you to take a moment and check some of them out. You simply click and it will tell you what each of them does. And for example, set a date or time will give us a date picker, but also you don't want people free typing dates in text columns. So you want to use the proper type of a column to restrict it. If you've looked at views that have the ability to enter someone's email address or name and it pulls them up from Active Directory, that's this person column. So go through and check each of these out by simply selecting them. And then when you're done, we'll click Next. If I got the wrong type, I can make a different choice here. It's just that once I'm in here, I don't get any information on what each of these different types of columns is. I'm going to enter the name category, and SharePoint is happy to autocomplete with things I don't want here. And my choices, as you'll recall, are draft, review, final, inactive. But this doesn't make them choices. This is just my description. It would help a user conceivably to hover over this, but we're going to use choice one for draft, choice two, review, choice three, final. And don't worry, as you enter out of final, it will give you the other choice for inactive. And these categories describe our document process. If I want to change any of the conditional formatting here, I can. So if I would like draft to be a different color, for example, this light orange, I can do that. Review, final. I actually don't like that color choice of gold sitting on that light goldenrod. So I'm going to choose something really solid for final. And inactive and draft I've made look a lot the same. That's probably not good. Maybe I should choose something different for draft. That's a little stronger of a choice. And it's always helpful if you have choices that can be described. If you're talking to somebody, choose red for draft, green for review, dark indigo for final, and for inactive, we're going to choose gray. It kind of looks, you know, graystone inactive. Now, we have some other options related to the choice type. One is, can a user add a value manually? If, for example, they didn't want to enter draft, review, final, or inactive, could they type in something else? And the answer in this business setting is no. This is our process. It's a four-step process. If we allow users to enter values manually, it's like they're typing them in Excel, but it doesn't add them to the list. And then, is one of these the default value? Well, we could make draft the default value. Every time somebody starts or uploads a new document, it starts in draft form. If that's how our business process works most of the time, that makes sense. But if not, don't put a default in unless it really is the choice that will be made most of the time by people adding a document to this library. At the bottom, we have more options. And this is where you could choose radio buttons instead of a drop-down menu, allow users to multi-pick if it made sense for them to choose two or more values. If you're going to force your users to enter information in this column, then you would turn this on here. What I will tell you is none of the documents you have will have that information if it's a brand new column. And so if you intend to force users to enter the values, you might want to leave this set at no to begin with. Go in and enter the values for the existing documents and then come back and turn this on, because otherwise you'll be told immediately, hey, you have documents here that don't meet the rules that you've set up for this column. They don't have their metadata. So I'm not making any changes to the options under More Options. I'm simply going to click Save, and here's our new category column. So if I want to edit the values in this column, I can swing into Edit and Grid View, and I can choose. For example, all of these are final documents, so in grid view, I can just use that fill handle like I would in Excel, and now they're all marked, all final documents, and leave the grid view, just like that. And I've changed this all in SharePoint. Here we are in Teams, and if I take a step sideways to any other channel and then come back to my locations, general channel, and go to the Files tab, there we go. One library, one set of views.